sun burns cold. We're building something unbreakable.
Not bad, actually. I'll show you guys this new car. Guys, this thing is finally here. It has turned out to be one of the best boats I've ever seen, and possibly one of the best fishing boats under 5 meters that I've ever seen. Maurtech have absolutely smashed it out of the park. There is so many things on this boat, and honestly, I don't even know. Let's just do a walkthrough.
Now, these Maurtech Marine boats are seriously built tough. This boat has a 4mm alley hull, completely sealed foam-filled deck, and extremely high sides at 700 mils. Paired with the 140 litres of onboard fuel, it makes this boat extremely seaworthy and extremely capable.
So I'm going to firstly start off with the trailer, because obviously the boat is insane, but the Maurtech trailers, they're probably one of the best trailers in the business, and I'll show you why. Come in closer, Jack. So these things are fully aluminium built, and they're fully built to the actual boat's hull, so no trailer that they make is the same. So the benefit of having a trailer that fits directly to this hull of the boat, or any hull for that matter if you want to get a trailer made, is it's so much stronger and so much better for the support of the hull. So the stringers inside the boat actually sit directly on these beams of the hull, which means there's so much extra support and the strength is so much better than your normal general trailer that fits any sort of boat, because you never know where they actually sit. Now, if you come around here, Maurtech actually include lights on both the side. Little things, just standard, makes it a little bit safer out in the road. And my favorite part, you can walk all around on this. It is extremely strong, and you can make your way around the whole boat. So that means you can get up and you can get something out of it without having to step on just this, but you can walk around the whole thing. Now, if you come around here, this is a game changer, honestly. These boat buckles are so good. What they do is they're a hard mounted boat buckle. So you can push this in here and that just releases it. When you're back ready, up the ramp again, put it on, grab these two and tighten it. Boat's not going anywhere. It is so good. This boat actually has a complete drive on trailer. So that means when you're by yourself or with someone, you just have to back the boat in the ramp, drive it straight on, hook it up front, and you're ready to go. If you come up here, again, one other thing. Now the jockey wheel, I've seen this on another creator's YouTube, and it's something that I've never actually realized, but Maurtech do it perfect. So they have the jockey wheel on the driver's side of the car. Now that means that you don't have to hop over, because I know my previous tinny and a lot of the generic brands of trailers actually put the jockey wheel on the passenger side. That means you have to jump over and you have to put it down, and it just creates a little bit more effort. And of course, like I always used to do, you bang your knee on the trailer. All right, let's get back to the boat. But this wrap has turned out so well. As you can see, it's got the Nomads. Who would have thought the Nomads would be on my boat? But anyway, got Jamie Vogar, the Nomads YouTube page, and then all the sponsors that have jumped on board. There is so many, but you guys are absolutely legends. Wet Sounds, Roadtech Marine, and Halco. Thank you guys so much for the support. But this wrap here was made by Startup Visuals. Sam, you're a legend. If you guys in Perth need a wrap, go hit her up. Now around to the powerhouse of the boat. So this is a Mercury Command Thrust 90 horsepower outboard. It is extremely lightweight, extremely powerful, and believe it or not, we're pushing 30 knots out of this thing, and we can even change the pitch of the prop, and I reckon we could probably squeeze a little bit more, maybe 34 knots. So that is a lot of power for a 4.8 meter boat, and I'm extremely happy with it. And the reviews that these things get, it's exactly what I'm after. Plus, they look the part. Now, if we come around to the bottom here, what you'll see here is a light. Now, the guys down at Wet Sounds or Total Mining Marine chuck this on. It's a blue light. It lights up the whole bottom of the boat. And when we're out later on this trip, when we go at night, I'll show you guys. It looks so, so specky. The lights on this boat lights up like a Christmas tree. Now, the ladder. Obviously, when you're diving, you want a good ladder. This thing is extremely strong. You're not going to hurt your feet in that. You can easily get up. It sits so low in the water. Absolutely perfect. So this here is the bait board. It's the main office where you spend a lot of time and stuff like that. I don't really do too much bait fishing, but it's perfect for exactly this. So you open this hatch up and you can just pull your lures out. So of course, all my slide dogs are just chilling in there, and it's just so easy just to be able to get them up. You can even put them in this back slot here. It fully drains off the edge. Cup holders, chuck your beers in there, whatever you need, and I absolutely love it because I'm quite a neat and tidy person, so when it comes to putting your stuff away in hatches, it's exactly what I want. Well, all of Maurtech boats are actually built to survey standard. Well, they can if you want them to be anyway. So if you look down here, one of the things that Maurtech do is they put their isolator switch in a separate compartment. That's just one of the things you need for survey. And while I'm here, I'll show you this as well. So if you come in here, right there is your fuel switch, so you can turn your fuel off if you need to, and you can also turn the deck wash off if there's any issues like that. Now, if you come around the back here, this is another thing that I've seen Maurtech do that no other boat does, and they actually put their fuel filter in this little compartment here. So if you notice on any other boat, usually the fuel filter will just sit at the back just here, and it goes rusty and just turns pretty average, so I think that's pretty smart. So we'll start in the cockpit. How cool is this reverse facing cabin? It is so awesome. And it just means that the light doesn't reflect on all the windows and stuff when you're driving at night. It is so good. Up here, we've got the wet sound system. Now, this thing is mint. It is so, so loud. I'll have to show you guys at a later date. But we've got 4 8-inch speakers around this boat that pack an amazing punch. They're honestly so loud. Now up front here we've got the two screens, so we've got the Lowrent Elite 9 and we've got the Raymarine Axiom Pro 9-inch as well. These things are so good. This thing even plays YouTube and Netflix, which is epic. Now here we've got the Mercury control system. That just tells you your trip meter, your fuel economy, where your fuel's at, your revs, all that sort of stuff, just on a fancy little gauge, which is pretty cool. Here's all the switches, which are awesome, and the game changer, an electric anchor. How good is that? The American Eagle A200, supplied by the guys at Maurtech Marine. Absolutely awesome. What? All right, while we're down the back here, we've got a live bait tank. Pretty cool. Now, in here, we've got deck wash. This thing is so powerful. I have to show you guys. It's so good to clean this floor. Now, while we're on the floor, how cool is this? The Nomads have been engraved. We've got a measurer. Probably need a bit bigger for my fish. Need to end it up here or something. But it's fully around the edges. It is so nice under tow. And it comes all the way out the front. And up top here, we've even got the Maurtech logo. Now, how cool is that? All right, so lighting. Now, hardcore have lit up this boat like an absolute Christmas tree. Up front here, we've got the light bar, which shines perfectly that way. Now, if we come in here and look up, we've got one light here, and of course one light here that lights up the bait board and everything else behind, and one up here, which is perfect for not only when you're out fishing and stuff like that, but also when you're at home, when you've just been on a trip, or when you're going for a trip to set up the boat or pack it down, whatever you need to do. I think it's pretty cool. So down here we've got more storage. So this here is under the cockpit, under the cabin. Now you can get your electrics, you can get your steering wheel up through here, but there is so much storage. If I can open it, I've got my life jacket, it's got all the safety gear. I've got some clothes, I've got some food, all that sort of stuff I just keep in there. It is quite big, it goes the full length of this cabin here, so we can chuck anything in there, keep it dry. Now, under here, there's even more space. So what you can actually do here is you can actually get a plastic container built. That'll slide directly under there. You can put all your fishing stuff, all your, I don't even know, whatever the hell you want, you can put in there. But I haven't got one just yet, but I'll definitely be getting one made up because you can't have enough storage. Now, we've got two side pockets here. Everything on this boat is used. All, it's so much usable space. It is crazy. But we've got the two side pockets. They're deep. They drain. Perfect. Now, at the back here, we've got another storage. This here is just, I've just got my drink waters in. I don't know why. And we go to the other side of the boat. So in here is actually the fuel lines. It's very handy just to be able to get in there if you have a problem with your fuel or whatever. Just another thing about that survey standard. Oh, so I forgot to show you these guys. So we've got the 12 volt cigarette lighter. We've got the two USB thingos there. Got two more USBs just in there. That just means that I can charge the GoPro and the drone and my phone and all that sort of stuff through that. Makes it absolutely perfect. So up here, we've got another thing. It's not actually storage. Well, I guess it could be. Oh, hello. There's a manual for the wet sounds. but you can actually get in here, you can fiddle with the wet sounds and stuff like that. Another thing, just easy to access stuff. So of course when you're out in the boat with these tunes pumping, you're going to need some cup holders for your cold bevy. So this here, the boat has got 8 cup holders. Like, I don't even need 8, but why not? But they also act as sinker holders, which is why every single rod holder down the bottom of the boat has one. Put your rod in here, And of course, your sinker can just sit in here rather than it bashing against the side of the boat. I think it's pretty smart. And the circumference of these is actually the same width as a can or a stubby with a stubby cool around it. So it sits in there and it won't bounce out. Just little things, eh? Now here we've got the rod holders. So it's built perfect for what I do. I do a lot of trolling and pelagic fishing. So the one up here is facing a little bit out. This one is directly back. That means that we can have a rod running here. That can be out a little bit wider, and we can have the one here close to the boat or vice versa. And that just means it's not gonna be as many tangles and stuff like that. It's pretty smart if you ask me. And Maurtech did that off their back without even asking me, which is pretty cool. Now, storage. Storage is obviously a big thing in a boat. So we've got so much storage in this boat. Now these hatches actually open up and they go the full length of this casting platform. So in here, I've got my spear guns, 1.2 meters. They fit absolutely perfectly. We'll come to this one. In here, I've got my fins and my diving gear. And then if you come around the front, we've got this big one here that fits the Logix 1 meter fish bag. So I can put all my fish in there and they're out of the sun in the cooler bag. Absolutely perfect. Now under here, another big storage compartment. So we've got our life jackets, all the safety gear, all of the stuff that you don't want wet, all stays in here, perfect. All right, so a bit more with the electronics. So in here, it runs dual batteries. So this thing, it'll power the boat for pretty much more than I need it. So I actually have a solar panel to put on the roof, which I might, I'm not quite sure yet. It will be handy if I go on longer missions, but for now when I'm just doing day trips or overnighters, this is more than enough. I've also got the spare battery up front, so I really don't need too much else. And I really love having that Maurtech matting up top because I can stand up there, have a bit of a boogie, have a bit of a dance party, especially with these wet sound speakers pumping. Doesn't get any better than that. While you're there, Joe, I'll meet you around the other side and we'll show them how neat these electrics are. Look, I don't know much about electrics, but how neat is that to look at? Seriously. Everything about this boat is built so it's accessible and easy, which is so good. Like, having your electrics there, you don't have to get under a cabin or do any of that stuff. It just makes it so perfect, especially for what I do, going out remote places. You can just troubleshoot that so easily. So the legends at Maurtech Marine, I don't actually have the fridge freezer here, but they've given me this fridge freezer from Brass Monkey, and it's 75 liters. It sits perfectly here, acts as a seat. You can plug it into your 12 volt system, but the very nifty thing about it, which you'll see on this video that I'm showing you now, is you can actually, one, you can move the middle out so you can have one big freezer or one big fridge. Now it's 12 volts, so you can plug it in, but it's got this nifty little thing that it has a 15 amp hour battery that'll let it last about 12 hours by itself. So you can leave it here, you can have the battery in, you don't have to worry about plugging it in and draining your batteries down here, and you can just leave it running, which is perfect for an overnighter or something like that. And it's definitely gonna be used, and it's gonna sit right here, and I can't wait to use that. Well, I don't even know, I can't, there's so many things that just keep popping up that I keep mentioning and wanna show you guys, but of course it's gonna be in the videos coming up. So if there's any other questions, leave them below and I'll let you guys know. But I just wanna say thank you to you guys, because without you guys watching and supporting on TikTok, Instagram, YouTube, wherever else you've seen videos, this would definitely not have happened. And I am so, so grateful. I just can't wait to use it. This boat build has been literally a dream come true for me. It's something that I never thought would happen. I don't think it's something that people just plan, but we're a year in and God, I don't even know. I can't even believe it's happening. But thank you, firstly, to Maurtech. You guys are absolute legends. This boat has turned out to be more than I ever could have expected. It is just built tough. It is so strong and it's got my name literally written all over it. It is just so good. It's perfect. It's exactly what I'm after. You guys will see that in the upcoming videos. But yeah, to the Maurtech boys, thank you guys so, so much. And to your wives as well, thank you for letting them spend endless hours trying to get this thing ready and prep for this exact trip I'm on. And really, that's it. It's all led up to this moment, 6 months of building this boat. Can't wait to get it in the water. Can't wait to get it in the drink and actually catch some fish, do some missions, do some camping and stuff like that and test this thing out. So once again, thank you guys so much. Thank you to the friends and family involved. And leave your thoughts below. Let me know what you think. Cheers, guys. I appreciate all you so, so much.